Do y'all know what time it is? I said, do you know what time it is? It's time for KP's video news. That's right, KP's video news. KP's video news. That's right.
That's right. Okay, folks, how you doing? It's another day, and it's time for another story. And today I'm going to be talking about therapy and education here and employment. And so what we have is a group of black entrepreneurs that are basically launching a non-profit online therapy sessions to help people combat the coronavirus. And so it says hospitals are now over capacity and understaffed. Healthcare workers are overworked, with an increasing number becoming patients themselves due to a shortage of proper protective equipment and long-term exposure. Even more troubling, healthcare employees are put in the position of making life or death decisions concerning who gets proper care and who does not. Noble Touch, a New York City-based nonprofit organization specializing in bioenergetic medicine wellness services, is offering Power Up Your Immune System sessions to support the respiratory and mental health needs of the community during the coronavirus global pandemic. With an overburdened healthcare system, helping communities to access pranic healing and bioenergetic medicine system is an overlooked opportunity, and the Noble Touch staff by over 50 trained volunteer bioenergetic practitioners is ready to bridge that gap. Noble Touch is combating COVID-19 from an energetic perspective. This virus is alive and has a pulse that beats strong. Communities living under extreme stress, anxiety, and fear are essentially feeding the energy of the virus. People have lost income and are concerned about how they will pay their rent, how they will purchase food, and live from day to day. People are running out of options, and pranic healing is a great alternative because this method can be done remotely, meaning you don't need to see us in person. And bioenergetic medicine is a perfect complement to the allopathic medicine. Power Up Your Immune System wellness sessions are conducted online and designed to strengthen energetically the respiratory system and reduce the mental health stresses brought on by the coronavirus. As one participant shared, I was feeling very stressed with chest tightness and anxiety. I could not relax and felt like I was fighting a cold. After the session, I was pleasantly surprised. The tightness and anxiety were completely gone. I felt light and relaxed. That night I slept very well and awoke feeling recharged and rested. Since March, the Noble Touch has had 5 wellness sessions serving nearly 400 people. They look forward to supporting the overall wellness of underserved communities across the country impacted by the coronavirus. For more information on upcoming pop-ups, please contact us at info@thenobletouch.com. And that's info, I-N-F-O, at thenobletouch.com. info@thenobletouch.com. Founded in 2010, the Noble Touch, a 501c3 nonprofit, provides holistic approaches to health and wellness to transform the mind, body, and spirit. TNT is quickly becoming the leading provider of bioenergetic healing services in limited resource communities across New York City. The ultimate goal is to introduce and help people embrace the concept of benefits of bioenergetic medicine, which is non-toxic, preventative, restorative, and complementary to allopathic medicine. Learn more at www.thenobletouch.com. So that's www.thenobletouch.com. And I'll make sure I write that in so you can see that as well. Story number 2. We have unemployed African Americans should upload resumes to blackjobs.com. The global coronavirus pandemic has all Americans feeling financially burdened, but more African Americans are being affected, as there are currently more than 6 million unemployed claims across the country. Experts say that black unemployment could eventually be as high as 30%, but one website, blackjobs.com, is helping to solve the problem. The website easily allows qualified job seekers to connect with employers who are committed to diversity hiring. The site allows users to easily upload the resumes for free and even link their resume with their existing LinkedIn account. But are there really jobs available? Yes. Although there has been an exponential loss of jobs in the past month, there are still new job opportunities being created daily. In fact, the demand for work from home professionals has skyrocketed due to social distancing mandates. There are many new customer support related positions on the rise, as well as jobs in healthcare, higher education, offsite IT, delivery services, etc. Blackjobs.com, which is free to use for those who are unemployed, is an immediate solution to the drastic loss of jobs and black unemployment in general. Other job boards for African Americans to consider using is HBCUConnect.com and Diversity Job Board. So I'll make sure I write those in there as well as in my comments. All right, and here's story number three. Says this is a black doctor helping homeless people get tested for the coronavirus. Miami, Florida. And this is something that I had touched on the other day about the homeless people that will not be getting a so-called coronavirus stimulus check. They won't be getting one because, number one, they don't have an address. Number two, they haven't filed taxes. And so therefore, you know, if you're just living out on the street, where are you going to get a check sent to? So on with the story here. Dr. Armin Henderson, an internist at the University of Miami Health System, has been making efforts to help homeless people get tested for the coronavirus, as he believes that it is essential to protecting the public's health. He is also working with a number of community volunteers to provide the essential needs of the homeless during the pandemic. Homeless people, including those who are elderly and with compromised immune systems, are known to be at higher risk of being infected with the coronavirus. While authorities advise people to stay at home to prevent the spread of virus, homeless people had to sleep on the streets and use public facilities. Henderson saw this situation and he said he's trying to alleviate it. He first went to the homeless in Overtown neighborhood in Miami, equipped with medical masks, face shield, and gloves, and conducted COVID-19 testing to people. Most recently, Henderson said it taking swab samples from 15 people, which he would send to the lab for testing. He collected their contact information so he would be able to inform them of the results once available in a few days. More than that, he also partnered with organizations such as Smile Trust and Dream Defenders to provide food, hand sanitizers, and camping tents. Showering Love, a nonprofit, also joined in to provide mobile showers and clothing. Volunteers noticed that homeless people are still skeptical of the pandemic. It shows the importance to inform the homeless people how serious the coronavirus threat is, so they would really do the necessary practices to prevent being infected and spreading the virus. Henderson also hopes to bring more camping tents and conduct more C virus tests. He calls for the local government to step up in assisting homeless people during the pandemic, as the whole community is actually at risk. Just test everybody, especially people who are vulnerable, Henderson told the local media in Miami. These people are the most vulnerable. They are also the highest risk for getting the virus and for spreading it. So I agree with them there. You know, it's a lot of, you know, that's one segment of the people that have been overlooked. And They need to be tested, and they need help. They need help just like everybody else. They need it. I'm talking about the homeless people. They need help too. So let's get busy.
Do y'all know what time it is? I said, do you know what time it is? It's time for KP's Video News. That's right, KP's Video News.
Peace.